Hello, everybody, and welcome back to We've Gone Country. Today I'm going to be talking about the parade that I was in. So I downloaded a couple pictures here. I'm so sorry about the quality of this camera. It's very poor. It's not the camera, it's the lens, but whatever. All right, so this is the first picture I've got here. That's me right there. So Daisy obviously is the horse that I rode because Alea is just too spooky. And I wore a Santa costume, even though it is a gnome, like the theme was gnome. And the hat that I made flopped over. We couldn't get it to stand up, but that's okay. So they had all this cute Christmas gear for horses. So Daisy was fully decked out in Christmas gear. That's one view of it. Let me see if I can get this to come up. Nope, that's the video. Let's see, wrong way. There we go. Okay, so the next one is, this is us on the way over from the farm. We had to stop off at my friend's farm in Grafton. So this girl up here in the front, that's Nora. She's my friend. I used to board with her, and her horse, Red, is the horse that she's riding. And she's the girl who picked me up with her trailer, and she brought me over to our mutual friend's farm, and then that friend is in Grafton, and that person, her farm is where all of us, a big group of like, I don't know, maybe 10 of us, walked over from her farm to the parade. So yes, this is us. That's four of us anyway. I think this is the horse that our friend was riding over here. So let's see what the next picture is here. All right, so this is a picture of us actually in the parade. Red and I were first in the parade, so this was our lead van here, or I don't know, some kind of car hatchback. It was for my friend's training business and lesson business, so we were just all kind of supporting her business, basically. And that's us over there in the corner. Let's see if I can zoom in a little bit. We didn't get the greatest quality pictures, nothing professional, sorry about that. It's kind of fuzzy. But yeah, so that's actually us in the parade. Oh, okay, why are we skipping? Sorry. Where were we? Okay, so this one, I think, was the next one, yeah. Sorry, my computer's very sensitive. Anyways, okay, so that's us again. This one is, who took this one? This might have been Lisa, my friend from one of my jobs, that took this picture. She came and watched. She came and watched the parade because she lives in the same city. So you can see a little bit better our gear here. Daisy was wearing a Christmas halter over her bridle, and she had this cute little Santa hat on, and that hat had to be, it was like tacked to her bridle because she kept shaking it off. She did not like that hat. And then we've got the four little booties here, and we've got a saddle blanket, kind of like a half blanket here. And there was also a Christmas pad under the saddle. And then that's the hat my mom helped me make. So these little things here are braids. You can't really tell, I guess, in this picture, but that is gnome braids. And then this super, super long hat, which dragged very far behind me. And there's a couple other girls that rode with us. I don't know who they are. They were just part of the group that were riding in the parade with us. This is my friend Nora. Hi, Nora. riding Red. And then this was us riding out of our friend's farm. So there's another view of us in our outfits. I was wearing a jacket at this point because it was a long ride over from the farm. We probably walked for about a half an hour to 40 minutes before we got over there. So it was a long ride. It was a long day. And then once we walked over from the farm, this was the little rest area that we were at. It was a little grassy area right alongside where the parking lot where everybody was getting lined up for the parade. And so we took some pictures there because we had a little time. We stood there for, gosh, I think it was about 2 hours maybe. hour and a half, something like that. So it was like a 45 minute ride from the farm, from my friend's farm, over to this rest area. And then when we got to this rest area, then we met up with more people who had trailered in to the actual parade area instead of to my friend's farm. And we met up with a lot more horse people there, and we took lots of pictures. So it turned out to be actually a pretty nice warm day. You can see that it was very sunny. It was still cold, but it wasn't terrible, and it was very windy. I'd say that the wind was the worst thing. But for winter, I mean, it was a great day for a parade. It was sunny, it was beautiful, it was warm. Another thing I missed on our outfit here is one of my friends from my job, who also came to the parade, she made this for, I think, for her horse a while back, and it's got some bells on it. So that way Daisy was able to jingle. That was fun. Jingle bells are always more fun for Christmas parades. And that's another view of us at the rest stop, just waiting for our turn to go on. Daisy was very impatient. She didn't spook really at all. The only time she got a little bit upset was when there was a band that was kind of on the other side from us. So here we're facing the parking lot, and in the parking lot is where we had like a high school band, or actually a couple bands that were warming up, and they started like drumming really loud all together, very loud and fast, and that upset her, and she kind of got a little antsy, but for the most part, she was not spooky at all. I mean, she used to be a carriage horse, so she's very used to traffic and loud noises, and that kind of stuff really doesn't bother her, so she was really good. The only thing that she wasn't good about is being near other horses. She was kind of snappy with the other mares. She didn't want to be anywhere near other mares, and if they got too close, then she started trying to kick them, and she was putting her ears back, and she was turning her butt toward them, and she even started like jumping in place and kicking out with both back feet while I was on her, which was not cool. So I had to keep moving her away from all the other mares because she was not liking them being around. But yeah, other than that, she was good. Obviously, she's very hot also, and so is my friend's horse, who I rode with. So she was, both of them kept running up on the truck, or the little hatchback, because they wanted to go faster. And everyone was just way too close together, and the parade was very, very slow. So all the horses were getting bunched up, and they wanted to keep going, and, you know, they wanted to get some energy out, and so during the parade, things got a little bit hairy. Daisy kept kind of walking out of line. Red had to be circled a lot because they just wanted to go faster. So because it was my first parade, Daisy's first parade, Nora's first parade, and Red's first parade, we didn't want to be in the front. But we ended up there because both of our horses were too hot to stay in the back. So we didn't really have a choice. They told us otherwise. And when a red mare tells you what she wants, you have to listen. That's just the way it is with chestnut mares. If you know horses, then you know what that means. So we accommodated her marishness and we dealt with it, but she was good. She was really good. So you can kind of see here my gnome hat a little bit more. My mom helped me make that. She did a great job. I mean, she pretty much made the whole thing. I just kind of helped with planning it, really. Buying materials, and I helped braid the hair, and that's about it. So this hat is supposed to be a gnome hat. I know it's supposed to be straight up, but I mean, this works. It goes all the way down here. It's very, very long. And the outfit I got from Walmart, surprisingly, Walmart online, it was only like $42. So, and I had these nice half sleeves here, so it was actually pretty warm. The skirt was really nice for riding because it, you know, splayed out really nice on the horse. So I had to make sure I got something nice and loose and like circle skirt so it would go out around the saddle, and it worked really good. And then underneath it, I was wearing my winter riding pants, so they're lined with fleece. And that worked really, really nice in the cold wind. And then my winter riding boots, which are also insulated. So it worked out really good for winter riding. Here's another view of us at the farm. So just kind of riding out from the barn and setting off on our adventure together with all of our team here. It was a lot of fun. It was a long day, but it was a lot of fun. And then this is us at that rest station again. I don't even really know who this is. I don't even remember what we talked about anymore. That's how bad my memory is. But she was nice, and obviously Daisy loves kids. I mean, look at her face here. This mare loves kids. She's so good with them. Now, adults, not so much. But she's like, oh, all about the kids. All about those kids. Yeah, so this was part of our team. These trailers back here, this is where people were meeting up and bringing their own horses. So you can see all the trailers lined up here. There were a lot of people that showed up, and somebody even brought a baby. Right here, I think, I think it's a weanling, or maybe a little older than weanling. Little foal, Arabian foal. She did pretty good. She seemed like a pretty fully trained, but well exposed for her age sort of filly. She did really well. And then this is Nora in Red, along with me and Daisy. I don't know if Daisy remembered Red from when we used to board together, but I don't think they were really friends before. But as soon as she saw, as soon as she heard him on the trailer, when they came to pick us up, she was nickering at him and she was all excited to be with him. And I didn't even really have to load Daisy on the trailer. She literally loaded herself. She just, as soon as she saw that trailer, she was nickering to this horse, to Red, and she was like quivering in excitement and just eager to get on that trailer. So all Nora had to do was open the door, and I put the lead rope over Daisy's back and she loaded herself just right on the trailer, no problem. She wanted to be with Red. And she was just obsessed with him. So like, she was all over that horse all day. So we stuck together for the whole ride. We had a lot of fun. So horses often do bond on a trailer together because they feel scared on the trailer. They don't know where they're going, especially if they're not used to trailering. And horses do have a tendency to form quick bonds on a trailer, but these two had already known each other. So I think the bond happened even faster. But yeah, Daisy was very, very obsessed with him, which is good. So at least she had a riding partner, and at least Red's not a mare, so she wasn't mad at him, and it was great. they made a good team together. So I think that's it. So then here, I've got a video that my mom took while we were out in the trailer. So I'll let you watch us go by. Hear the wind. It was very, very windy. You see how Daisy kept trying to edge out of line because she wanted to walk and I wouldn't let her. And so you can see how we had to keep starting and stopping, and horses weren't very fond of that. For the most part, though, everyone was really good. Nobody really spooked majorly. Red spooked once, but he just kind of sidled to the side just a little bit. Didn't go very far, so it was all good. Despite all the loud noises and the music and the sirens and the wind, they all did really, really well. So this was our whole group here. There's that foal I was talking about. Giving that pony some exposure. It's awesome. Thank you. So anyways, yeah, I just wanted to give you guys a chance to see what we did at the Christmas parade, and that's it. And I wish I could have gotten some more footage. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to. I was too busy. So anyways, but at least you got a taste of what we did. It was a lot of fun. And Nora and I definitely want to do it again next year. So yeah, so that's the Christmas parade. And I will probably be taking more footage again today, but we'll see. I know Andy's gonna be working on putting the boiler up tonight with one of his family members. So I may very well get some footage of that tonight. So I will keep you guys updated. So tune in again and see what's going on around the farm. There's always something going on here.